Look at all these dead animals right here. I'm about to consume some sentient beings. Look at that. Them gains right there. That's gains. I'm gonna turn all that protein, all that fat, all these carbohydrates into gains. Mmm. Good morning. You thought I was gonna say good humans. Just good morning, because I'm not Australian. I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit today about what you can do better. This is for new people. What you can do better and what my thoughts are on how to do better on your local group ride, kind of your local fast ride. Everybody has that one in your area. If you haven't found it yet, you will. As your fitness level grows, you might be brand new to cycling right now, and you might just be out doing some solo rides. Maybe you have a little club of guys, and you're doing some little smaller group rides, but you will eventually branch into a bigger ride, kind of like what you see right now. This is our Tuesday morning ride, kind of showcasing the first climb, and I'll have this sprint after this first climb here, and after I chat a little bit with you guys. Progression is you get a bike, you ride a little bit, you're like, oh, I start feeling good, you start losing a little bit of weight. That's what happens when you exercise. Crazy concept, I know. And you start trying to find other people to ride with, and you kind of push yourself a little farther on the bike. You start getting a little faster, and then it just keeps going. Then you eventually find these rides. So there's definitely one in your area. ask the local bike shops, you know, hit the forums, whatever it is. Find this local ride. And for those of you that are on these kind of rides already, for those of you that are, you know, just now getting on the ride or kind of mid-pack, I'm going to offer some tips and advice to those people. If you are on the front of the ride that I'm talking about, you're probably just watching this video just because it's entertaining, and that's cool too, and I appreciate that. But these thoughts might not be for you because they're pretty simple to an advanced level rider, but nothing that ever really got told to me. Stuff I just kind of worked out on my own. And again, they're simple once you put them into practice, but it would have been nice for someone to kind of let me know, hey, this is what you could do better to do better on these rides. And yes, this is a training ride, but I mean, we all kind of come out for our own, we have our own agendas. And I would say this is close to competition as a lot of us are ever gonna get, myself included. I might try to race this next year, but I just wanted to give you my thoughts on how you can hang on a little longer, maybe, you know, and possibly even be at the front of the group or in that A group as it breaks up, as most of these groups will do. You get like an A and a B kind of over these climbs, and, you know, just try to stay on the group in front of you a little better. So now, after that rant's over and I kind of explained what I want to talk about, the thought process that I have when I approach these rides, and I'm kind of now slowly starting to get to that front group and kind of be able to play in the front group. But what I've learned along the way, number one thing is you have to be spinning all the time. The most important piece of equipment you can purchase, I would say besides a power meter, which I can spend an hour talking about power meters, is a cadence sensor. And, you know, if you can't afford a power meter right now because you just used all your savings to get a bicycle and shoes and helmet and glasses and whatever, go buy a cadence sensor at least. They're 30 bucks. Garmin sells one. It rubber bands onto your crank arm. You need something to read it. Hopefully at this point you have a Garmin. If not, you can actually get one of the little cheap, like Specialized makes like a little $40 box that'll tell you your numbers. Get that set up. Know your cadence. From that point forward, it's just a spin off. Spin all the time. There is a limit to that, you know, and that's where your cadence sensor is gonna let you know. I have an alarm set up to beep at 110 RPM to let me know my Garmin will beep, lets me know, hey, too much spinning. I'll obviously feel it before that beep goes off, but for a new person, it might be nice to have that alarm set up. So I try to stay 95 to 105. I would say 9 times out of 10, if you're getting dropped, when you get dropped, that moment of when you give up and you throw in the towel, if you could look right then at your cadence, right before you let off the group and get dropped, your cadence has dropped below 90. And it's dropped into the 80s, and you've just created a lactic acid bomb in your legs, and eventually just goes boom, and you're off. Know that it's contradictory to what you think. Know that shifting into an easier gear and spinning more, you look at my RPMs right now, I'm up around 100, 105. while it feels like you're gonna go slower, and you probably will lose some mile an hour, you're going to stay moving forward. You're not gonna get popped. You're going to just slow down, if that's your fitness, and you're gonna continue, though, your forward progress. Someone might come around you, you might fall just a few bikes back, but you're not gonna pop yourself. You will never, the word getting popped, it really is in the legs, less in your lungs. You will only ever just slow down when you can't breathe. when you can't catch your breath, you're just gonna slow down, you're not gonna pop off the back. Whereas if you let your legs pop, you are gonna just, like, you have to stop pedaling, and that's getting popped. So cadence is the one thing I wanna preach in this, this is the Hummingbird Climb Tuesday morning. I wanted to preach cadence to you guys. Buy a cadence sensor. If you can buy a power meter, they'll have a built-in accelerometer that's gonna tell you cadence as well. All the stages, cork, everything now is gonna have that built in. Obviously power and cadence are all you need. You can do heart rate, the old school guys do that, but I'm not a heart rate guy. Buy a cadence sensor, keep your RPMs high. If your RPMs, like you see mine drop here 74, I'm out of saddle. That's different, I'm kind of changing things up. So cadence is number one. Number two on these group rides, sit in and pick a good wheel and spin. There's my rant on cadence. We're just getting finished up with this climb here. I think I'm second over the top. I do fairly well. I was pretty happy with my performance here over the top. Next up's gonna be the sprint on Lafayette. Check it out. Tuesday morning sprint. The guy who won last week, Rob, is sitting right in front of me, and he doesn't know that I'm behind him. I shuffled around a bit. I played a little sneaky this week, and I end up getting the win by maybe an arm's length, not even that. It was a, I want to say, like, five-man sprint, so a full field sprint here at the end. And Rob ended up saying he didn't know I was behind him until I was coming around him.